to millions of Filipinos her brand of leadership with Manasaki. Media friends, let's all welcome Secretary Judy Taguiwalo. Good evening. It has been a long day. I have just come back from the closing ceremony of the 30th ASEAN Summit. I'm happy to be here. I would like to first read to you my statement. As the chair of the ASEAN Socio-Cultural Community Council, or the ASCC, I would like to extend our appreciation to our leaders for a fruitful conclusion of the 30th ASEAN Summit. We are enthused as the ASEAN leaders adopted and signed the ASEAN Declaration on the Role of the Civil Service as a Catalyst for Achieving ASEAN Vision 2025. This declaration, as Chairwoman Bala must have shared with you already, highlights the critical role the civil service plays in ASEAN community building. The ASEAN leaders also supported the conclusion of the ASEAN Instrument on Migrant Workers and see through its signing during the 31st ASEAN Summit in November here in the Philippines. The ASEAN Summit with the Philippine Chairship highlights the camaraderie among our nations with the common goal of uplifting the lives of our people in the region. Looking forward, the ACC is confident that it will endorse to the ASEAN leaders in the 31st ASEAN Summit in November 5 outcome documents. Once adopted, the following will benefit the marginalized and vulnerable sectors. The ASEAN Instrument on the Promotion and Protection of the Rights of Migrant Workers, the ASEAN Leaders' Declaration on the Gender-Responsive Implementation of the ASEAN Community Vision 2025 and Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations, the ASEAN Leaders' Declaration on Ending All Forms of Malnutrition, the ASEAN Leaders' Declaration on Commitment on Antimicrobial Resistance, Combating AMR Through One Health Approach, and the ASEAN Leaders' Statement on Youth Development Index. These documents, which are aligned with the ASEAN Socio-Cultural Community Blueprint 2025, intend to influence policy and program development in ASEAN member states. Moreover, under the purview of the ASCC, there are a number of commemorative activities lined up for the golden anniversary of ASEAN. Allow me to highlight the following activities that will be hosted by the Department of Social Welfare and Development, DSWD, this golden anniversary of ASEAN. We will host an ASEAN High-Level Conference on Social Protection in Manila on August 18 to 20 this year. It aims to provide a venue for interactive discussion, consultation, and sharing of good practices among national and international organizations in social protection. The conference will also serve as venue to discuss updates from AMS relative to the adoption of the declaration and framework and action plan. We will also host a cross-regional meeting for advancing the protection of children from violence, which will convene in Manila this June 6 to 8. It is an annual gathering organized by the United Nations Special Representative of the Secretary General on Violence Against Children. The meeting will provide a venue to discuss updates on the efforts of the government, civil society, and other stakeholders, highlight the role of children in eliminating violence against children. Meanwhile, two key health-related activities will also be hosted through the leadership of the National Nutrition Council and the Department of Health. One is the ASEAN Conference on Nutrition and Breastfeeding in August 5 in Manila, and Traditional Medicine Conference, Milestone Achievements of ASEAN Member States, this coming September 26 to 27. That would be all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Secretary Judy.